Hi everyone, Ian Van Tile here, and behind me is a new listing of mine for a 1989 Taswell 43. So let me show you some of the features and benefits that this particular vessel has to offer.
So here we are looking at the 1989 Taswell 43. This particular vessel is located in Coronado at the Coronado Yacht Club. This is a very unique vessel to the West Coast. This is a very sturdy, solid offshore vessel. And I'm gonna show you a lot of the features. Not gonna hit on every aspect, but you'll definitely understand the vessel the time we're done. Double bow roller system, rocking an anchor here up to the electric windlass. As we carry back aft, you're gonna see these beautiful varnished tow rails here with properly led lines to the cleats. So they actually support the vessel in the true stance that it is. I'll walk you up on the foredeck here as we enter the vessel. But again, and looking at the boat, it really has those true classic lines. Leisure boom furl in a white painted mast. This is a double spreader rig as well too. Isolated backstay, and all of the rigging has been replaced as well too. The top sides have also been done by a two-part epoxy paint, and she looks just gorgeous. Working our way to the transom of the vessel, we have the dinghy down in the water right now, but this does raise up on this double stainless steel davit system here with a really nice purchase system off the back of the boat. This will show you the access right here to the stern. Nice stainless steel guardrail here. Just above that is the exhaust swim platform and then a swim step ladder so you can allow access right to the back of the vessel. Here on the stern rail, we have the stainless rear aft lifelines. We also have built-in seats as well too. And then the running backs with their adjustable purchase system. As we come aboard the vessel, again, everything from the attention to detail, just to the quality of work that has been done by this particular builder has really stand out. There's even deck prisms down here as well too, to let light in. But again, you can see beautiful decks. Everything's very well taken care of and definitely show a lot of pride and ownership. We have a door out up here with a stainless steel guard, two overhead opening hatches into the forward stateroom, and then also a solar vent. The inner staysail is here, and then as you can see, this is our electric windlass with a switch right here. Solid stainless steel construction here at the bow section, rolling into the double bow roller system. Harken furlers as well, and really nice high-end lines. Moving our way back aft, again, you can see the profile of the deck, the leisure furl boom. All this is in really beautiful condition, very well taken care of, as I mentioned. And we have these nice solid stainless steel braces here on the side of the mast. Again, opening hatches that are really in nice condition as well too. We have the Dodger with roll-up center window, and then we have a connector, and then the bimini itself. Working our way to the aft decks, you can see the main sheet system here with the traveler just aft of the cockpit, so that's easy accessible as well too. And then again, we have this aft deck area with two lockers here. Access into the aft boarding entrance is what I was talking about earlier, and just a great layout. This opening hatch leads into the aft master cabin. And as we come into the cockpit, you could see this really nice cockpit design here. We have cushions here underneath the cushions. This is teak as well too, teak flooring. And then we have our wheel, this stainless steel spoked rim with a really nice varnished wood trim here. We have our autopilot. And then just above that is our B&G GPS plotter. Our windlass control switch here. Our Yanmar instrumentation panel is just off to the starboard side. Again, giving us really nice access. And then we have a cockpit table that folds out as well. Companionway doors that open up. Again, these are really nice because they can be fully removable if so desired. Great stainless steel grab handles as we come down below the companionway. Here we have our Raymarine RL70C. This is our colored radar. And then just above that is a multi-repeater B&G instrument. All right, as we come down below the vessel, you're gonna kind of be coming into the salon itself, and just off to starboard is our galley. Forward of that is the nav station, but it is just a beautiful vessel down below. The galley is equipped with double stainless steel sinks, and these are deep sinks as well too. And then we also have access to the refrigerator here, very well insulated. And again, top loading access as well too. And then there we go. Look at that, that large compartment down there with that cold plate. Just above us is our microwave. We have a 12-volt fan. Overhead, we have the solar fan that's running here. Three-burner stove and oven. This is a Force 10. And then we also have the digital controls, thermostats for the fridge and freezer compartment. Lots of storage here in the galley. This is our gas valve as well, too. And then again, just the attention to detail, the woodwork on all of the cabinetry is just really beautiful of how that's all set up and how it's designed. And then, you know, this additional storage, this opens up. But yeah, really tastefully done. But a great galley for an offshore cruiser. It really gives you something to kind of stand in here and brace yourself in. As I mentioned, forward of the galley is the nav station. The nav station set up with a chair here that kind of pivots. And then we also have a Raymarine package set up here, ICOM, VHF, and then our second GPS display. This is the SSB radio that's obviously tied into that backstay as well too. 12-volt fan, and then your classic clock and barometer here. But you can see this is built in, you know, obviously Taiwan. Here we have the hull number 42, and it is just a classic masterpiece. Moving up forward, we have obviously the keel stepped mast here. A little small step down here, access to the bilge. Moving up to the forward cabin, lots of storage here, outboard storage behind this large mirror, hanging locker storage, and then storage even under the bed. This is a double bunk bed here. And what's really neat about it is, again, this can actually fold down so you can turn it into a couch and really just kind of separate it in a couple different manners here. But yeah, it is nice to be able to have two berths up forward if so desired. Again, 12-volt fan, LED lighting, two overhead opening hatches, lots of storage everywhere. As we move up forward of this, we go into the head and shower compartment. This is a wet head, but there is a platform seat that drops down over the toilet bowl itself. They're electric toilets. And again, lots of room space here, two opening hatches, and again, lots of storage throughout. When this drops down, and then we have access into this forward storage area, and just forward of that is the anchor locker. But again, that's one thing this yacht does not lack is storage for its size. And again, just a lot of opening hatches everywhere we go. Really beautiful teak, great floor too, with the drain built into that. All right, nice perspective looking aft into the forward cabin. Again, and these are large berths as well too. So yeah, really set up quite nicely. All right, moving our way back aft. I want to also point out that this particular vessel has air conditioning. We also have a generator as well too. We have the charger and inverter right here. This is our heart. That's our generator remote switch. The companionway steps do remove, so we have access to the forward part of the engine. But now let's talk about the salon. So the salon itself is quite gorgeous. We have this really nice U-shaped seating around the salon table. The table does drop down as well too. Battery switches there. Overhead, we have two opening hatches, these large windows that let a lot of natural light in, side hole ports as well too. You'll find that on starboard and port side, again, with additional storage as well, and there's storage underneath all of this seating. All right, moving our way back aft, lots of access points into the engine room. There's the engine right there into the engine room. Just behind that is the generator. Very, very clean. The bottom paint was just recently done, along with 8 through holes being replaced. We have our DC power here, and then our AC power switch here. So this is all nicely done as well. And then we have our you know, gauges here. So we have four water tanks, and then a fuel tank, and then we also have the holding tank there as well too. Bilge pump, manual, and auto switch as well too. But yeah, really nicely set up. All of this area is all storage, as you can see. And again, it's just so cool how they've designed this. That can be a, you know, a wet foul weather gear hanging locker, And again, just so much storage, and it's all ventilated as well too. So nothing can kind of, you know, get foul in there as well too. Everything can breathe on the boat. Now we're making our way to the aft cabin. So the aft cabin has its own door here. We have accessibility into the engine generator room here, additional storage, and then hanging locker space behind the door here, lots of cabinets and shelving. A really amazing aft cabin. We have bench seats on both sides of the foot of the bed, and those also have storage below them. A large center line, you know, aft berth as well too. And then, I mean, as I move in, let me show you this. We have an opening hatch there. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4. So we have 5, 6, and then we go into the head compartment, 7, 8, and then overhead, 9. It's just amazing how they designed this vessel with just so many opening hatches as well too. Just forward of the berth, we have a little vanity here, a full mirror, and then a little desktop. Moving into the head shower compartment, this is an electric toilet as well too, a separate sink basin and a separate shower compartment. So this is really nice being able to have that separate shower compartment. And then obviously to kind of close this off, you can have a little, you know, divider here if so desired, a little shower curtain. But yeah, great use of space, lots of space here. Again, additional access into the engine room from here. So there's no shortage of engine access space or storage on this yacht. All right, coming back through, looking at this aft cabin. I'm gonna close the door here. Again, you kind of get the feel of just the fit, the finish. The woodwork is gorgeous here. And again, just really, you know, tastefully done here for an offshore cruiser. Moving our way back up into the salon. And there we have it. Well, I hope you found this video to be helpful and informative. If you would like more information in regards to the 1989 Taswell 43, please feel free to contact myself, Ian Van Tile, at any time, day or night. I look forward to hearing from you and hopefully earning your business and getting you and your family and friends out on the water. Thank you again, and talk to you soon. Bye for now.